Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Labrik. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Sakhir Palace the Speaker of the Representatives Council Ahmed bin Ibrahim Al Mulla and the Chairman of the Shura Council Ali bin Saleh Al Saleh, as well as a number of members of the councils who presented to His Majesty the Parliament's annual report of the fourth legislative term's third session. His Majesty expressed pride in the efforts of the council in the service of the kingdom and its people. He hailed the effective role of the legislative authority in consolidating the foundations of the parliamentary process, enhancing its contributions to comprehensive development, and adopting the causes of the Bahraini society. His Majesty highlighted the achievements of both councils and their pivotal role in developing laws and legislations consolidating the foundation of the state of institutions and law, defend the cause of the kingdom in all events, and extend friendship ties to different friendly nations. His Majesty also commended the content of the annual report and the inclusion of tools to develop the legislative and regulatory performance. He also expressed aspirations for the new session to make more achievements that would serve the kingdom. His Majesty expressed pride in the contributions of the people of Bahrain in all fields, commending their important role in developing the kingdom. The parliamentary report included statistics concerning the council's discussions and activities. The report is considered the result of the directives of His Majesty the King in support of democracy. It also affirms the efforts of the members of the Representatives and Shura Councils to perform their national duty. The Representatives Council report included the achievements made during the previous session, as well as the mechanisms and methods employed to develop parliamentary work. Al-Mulla attributed the achievements of the Council to the support of His Majesty the King through constructive cooperation with the government led by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, and to the support of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander, and First Deputy Premier, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace his personal representative for charity work and youth affairs, President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and Chairman of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and First Deputy President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, President of Bahrain Athletics Association, and the Honorary President of Bahrain Mixed Martial Arts Federation, MMAF, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Highness Sheikh Nasser presented to His Majesty the Bahraini delegation participants in the fifth edition of the Asian Indoor and Martial Art Game, which took place in Turkmenistan recently, headed by the Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Environment and the President of Bahrain Royal Equestrian and Endurance Federation, Brief, Sheikh Faisal bin Rashid Al Khalifa. The kingdom won 2 gold medals and 1 bronze in the games. His Majesty congratulated the participants on this honorable achievement, hailing the determination of Bahrain youth who proved their ability to compete in various sports. He also commended the support of His Highness Sheikh Nasser and his efforts in serving Bahraini sports. His Majesty also praised the efforts of His Highness Sheikh Khalid and his continuous follow-up that contributed to achieving advanced positions in many athletics and mixed martial arts competitions. His Majesty highlighted the role of Bahrain Olympic Committee in creating plans and programs that aim to develop various sports and those that left profound impact on making many achievements in various competitions, lauding the efforts of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports Affairs and the Ministry of Youth and Sports Affairs to encourage the effective participation of Bahraini youth in various sports. His Majesty expressed thanks and appreciation for the athletes' efforts in the championship and those of various Bahrain federations, wishing everyone success and expressing hope that the kingdom would make further achievements. The Assistant Secretary General of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and Secretary General of Bahrain Olympic Committee, Abdurrahman Askar, delivered a speech in which he expressed thanks and gratitude for His Majesty's unlimited support to the athletes, which was reflected in the achievements they made. He stated that the achievement is a result of His Majesty's support and encouragement and the directives and follow-up of His Highness Sheikh Nasser. He expressed thanks and appreciation to Sheikh Faisal bin Rashid Al Khalifa, the President of the Bahrain delegation, for his efforts and follow-up on the participants' preparations. He wished His Majesty abundant health and happiness.
لأبنائكم الرياضيين والذي كان له الأثر البارز في تحقيق العديد من الإنجازات في مختلف الألعاب الرياضية وعلى مختلف الأصعدة والمستويات وها نحن اليوم سيدي صاحب الجلالة نتشرف بلقائكم لنقدم لجلالتكم جمعا جديدا من أبنائكم الأبطال الرياضيين الذين شرفوا مملكة البحرين ورفعوا رايتها عالية خفاقة وقوفهم على منصات التتويج في النسخة الخامسة من دورة الألعاب الآسيوية للصالات وفنون القتال التي احتضنتها العاصمة التركمانية أشخاباد بمشاركة 64 دولة تمثل قارتي آسيا وأقيانوسيا. سيدي صاحب الجلالة، لقد حاصت اللجنة الأولمبية البحرينية بقيادة ابنكم البار سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة على رفع شعار المشاركة من أجل المنافسة، وبما أن هذه الدورة قائمة أساساً على رياضة فنون القتال، فقد قرر مجلس الإدارة المشاركة فيها والتركيز على ألعاب فنون القتال. واستطعنا ولله الحمد والمنة ومن تحقيق إنجازات كبيرة في لعبة الجيجيتسو والمصارعة الحرة لتثبت قدرتنا التنافسية في هذه الألعاب ونبرز مكانتنا على الخارطة الآسيوية وهو ما يعد إنجازا مشرفا وضع البحرين في المرتبة 23 على قائمة الميداليات والمرتبة الثانية بعد كوريا الجنوبية في حساب النسبة والتناسب بين عدد المشاركين وعدد الميداليات الذهبية لكل دولة من الدول المشاركة في الدورة، متفوقين بذلك على عدد كبير من الدول التي تفوقنا تعداداً سكانياً، وتفوقنا في تعداد مشاركيها في الدورة. سيدي صاحب الجلالة، إن هذا الإنجاز وكل ما سبقه من إنجازات رياضية ما كان لها أن تتحقق لولا دعم جلالتكم السخي وتشجيعكم المتواصل لأبنائكم الرياضيين المتميزين، وهذا ما يزيدنا إصرارا وعزيمة لمواصلة العطاء من أجل إعلاء راية الوطن في كل المحافل الرياضية. كما أن توجيهات سيدي سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة كان لها الأثر البالغ في هذه الإنجازات بفضل رعايته ومتابعته واهتمامه الشخصي بشكل يومي. وليفوتني في هذه المناسبة التاريخية السعيدة أن أشير بكثير من الشكر والتقدير إلى سمو الشيخ فيصل بن راشد آل خليفة رئيس البعثة البحرينية على ما قام به من جهد كبير في متابعة تحضيرات الأبطال وتحفيزهم، فكان سموه مثالاً للقائد الناجح. والشكر موصول إلى جميع أعضاء البعثة البحرينية الذين كانوا خير سفراء لبلدهم في هذا المحفل الرياضي الكبير. سيدي صاحب الجلالة، في ختام هذه الكلمة لا نجد إلا أن نكرر شكرنا وامتناننا العميقين لجلالتكم، لاعين المولى عز وجل أن يمن على جلالتكم بموفور الصحة والعافية وطول العمر، ويسدد على طريق الخير خطاكم، ويجعلكم ذخرا وسندا لهذا الوطن الغالي. عشتم وعاشت البحرين تحت قيادتكم في أمن وأمان، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
The Royal Guard Commander, His Highness Brigadier General Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, visited today the Royal Communications Unit, accompanied by the Commander of the Royal Guard Special Force and a number of senior Royal Guard officers. His Highness was received by the unit's commander and a number of senior officers. The Royal Guard Commander was briefed on the development and preparation programs as well as the military training in the unit. His Highness Brigadier General Sheikh Nasser conveyed the greetings and appreciation of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to the officers for their noble sacrifice while fighting among the Arab coalition forces to support legitimacy in Yemen led by Saudi armed forces. His Highness thanked them for their high military professionalism during their participation with the Bahrain Defense Force in Yemen. His Highness highlighted the appreciation of the Arab coalition forces led by Saudi Arabia for the BDF officers' efforts, stating that this appreciation is a result of the officers' high combat efforts through performing their national duties, which are an implementation of the directives of His Majesty and the follow-up of the BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa. Under the patronage of the President of the Royal Life Saving Bahrain, Chairman of the Board of Trustees of the Isa bin Salman Educational and Charity Fund, His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, Royal Life Saving Bahrain today launched its water safety strategy for Bahrain in the presence of Chairperson and Founder of Royal Life Saving Bahrain, Her Royal Highness Sheikha Naila bint Hamad bin Ibrahim Al Khalifa. More in this report with Hiba Abdul Ghaffar.
Royal Life Saving Bahrain launches its water safety strategy, crafted in Bahrain, with the goals of developing a culture of swimming and enjoyment of water, promoting volunteerism and social cohesion, reducing water-related death and injury, enhancing the appeal of water-related tourism and fostering respect for coastlines and marine habitats.
Make sure that all the rules and regulations for coastal and water safety regulations will be implemented through our classification system to all hotels with swimming pools and the ones with beachfronts or waterfronts. This will, of course, enhance the safety of all Bahrainis, locals and tourists coming to Bahrain.
The water safety strategy was developed with international expertise and local consultation, knowledge and experience, aiming to unite our communities, institutions and local leader industry under a shared objective to educate and advocate a safer aquatic environment for citizens, residents and tourists in line with international standards.
Drowning is a leading cause of injury death worldwide. Almost one person drowns every minute worldwide. So we are very pleased that Bahrain is taking a lead in this issue internationally and really leading the way in preventing drowning and creating a water safety culture and making sure people can enjoy the beaches and the water parks safely. Also encouraging people to learn CPR and first aid, making sure that anyone can save a life.
Five independent strategies were discussed. First, teach swimming. Second, provide safe locations. Third, teach first aid. Fourth, develop life-saving people. And fifth, improve boating safety.
Work into developing this water safety strategy, and now we're hoping to work with industry, work with education, work with the ministries to now implement our objectives and our vision, and hopefully we'll see some success with that over the coming months. We have several courses coming up. We've got beach lifeguard courses at Marassi Beach in a couple of weeks. We've also got our first pool lifeguard courses, our first aid courses. They're all starting to run as well.
For the past year, we've been working on the water safety strategy. We've had some assistance from Australia. They've been visiting Bahrain along with our local team to kind of see what are the challenges we face in Bahrain with regards to water safety. And then out of our different visits, after seeing all of the different beaches, swimming pools, and what guidelines are currently in place in Bahrain, we've created the water safety strategy, which was launched today.
All activities will be implemented in close collaboration with local stakeholders from the government and both public and private sectors, together committed to build cohesive communities, enable economic development and save lives. Nothing can be more important than a human's life. Royal Life Saving Bahrain launches its water safety strategy today to make sure no life can be at risk. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Heva Abdelghafour.
The Representatives' Council held its second session of the fourth annual session of the fourth legislative term under the chairmanship of Representatives' Council Speaker Ahmed Ibrahim Al-Mulla and in the presence of members of the Council. The meeting was held today and began by reviewing 16 letters from the government, which include the following topics. The Decree of Law No. 36 of 2017, amending Article 3 of Decree Law No. 4 of 2001 concerning the prohibition and combating of money laundering and the financing of terrorism. Decree Law No. 37 of 2017, amending certain provisions. Decree Law No. 14 of Law No. 38 of 2017, amending some provisions of the Telecommunications Law, promulgating by Legislative Decree No. 48 for the year 2002. A draft law drafted on the law proposal in its amendment form by the Representatives' Council, amending some provisions of Law No. 13 for the year 1975 on the regulation of pensions and retirement benefits for government employees. A draft law drafted on the law proposal in its amendment form by the Representatives' Council, amending Article 59 of the Real Estate Registration Law, promulgating by Law No. 13 of 2013. In addition to a draft law drafted on the Shura Council's proposal to amend some provisions of Decree Law No. 27 for the year 2015 on the Commercial Register. A draft law ratifying the amended protocol to the Convention between the Kingdom of Bahrain and the Kingdom of Thailand on the avoidance of double taxation and the prevention of tax evasion in the case of income taxes, which is attached to Decree No. 52 for the year 2017. A draft law drafted on the law proposal in its amended form by the Representatives' Council, amending certain provisions of the Judicial Authority Law, promulgated by a Legislative Decree No. 42 of 2002. A draft law drafted on the law proposal in its amended form by the Representatives' Council, amending Article 35 of the Cooperative Societies Law, issued by Legislative Decree No. 24 for the year 2000. A draft law formed on the law proposal by the Shura Council to amend some provisions of Decree Law No. 55 for the year 2002 regarding the internal regulation of the Shura Council. A draft law drafted on the law proposal by the Representatives' Council on the prohibition of interests. A draft law drafted on the basis of a law proposed in its amended form by Representatives' Council, amending some provisions of the Penal Code promulgated by Legislative Decree No. 15 of 1976. A draft law drafted on the law proposal in its amended form by the Representatives' Council, amending Article 4 of Decree Law No. 11 of 1985 on the protection and support of national industries. A draft law drafted on the law proposal in its amended form by the Representatives' Council, amending Article 32 of the Decree Law No. 39 for the year 2002 regarding the general budget. A draft law drafted on the law proposal by the Representatives' Council to amend Article 32 of the Decree Law No. 39 for the year 2002 on the general budget, where the Council was notified of the referral of projects to the relevant committees. Concerning the third item, which includes the letters received from the Minister of Shura and the Representatives' Council Affairs, the Council decided to approve the transfer of the incoming messages to the next session upon the proposal by MP Khaled Ashar. In the fourth item, it was agreed to form a committee composed of council members to prepare a draft for a response to the royal speech as follows. Ahmed Abdel Wahid Qareta Rua Badr Al-Hayki Adil Abdel Rahman Al-Asumi Isa Abdel Jabbar Al-Kohiji Muhammad Ismail Al-Imadi Majid Ibrahim Al-Majid Dr. Majid Muhsin Al-Asfour and Muhammad Salman Al-Ahmed. In the fifth item, the members of the Executive Committee of the Parliamentary Division for the Kingdom of Bahrain were elected as follows. Jalal Kazim Hassan, Abdurrahman Rashid Boumjid, Isa Ahmed Turki, Nasser Abdurraza Al-Qasir. In the same session, the lists of candidates for membership of the five permanent committees of the Council were approved as follow. First, members of the Legislative and Legal Affairs Committee, namely Anas Ali Buhindi, Khalid Ashar, Fatima Abdel Mahdi Al-Asfour, Ali Hassan Al-Atish, Rahim Al-Majid, Muhammad Ja'far Milad, Muhammad Yusuf Al-Ma'rafi. Members of the Financial and Economic Affairs Committee are the MPs Ahmed Abdel Wahid Qarata, Jalal Kazim Hassan, Adil Hamid Abdel Hussein, Abdurrahman Ali Bouali, Dr. Ali Isa Bouferson, Muhammad Ismail Al-Imadi, Muhammad Salman Al-Ahmed, Dr. Majid Muhsin Al-Asfour. Members of the Foreign Affairs, Defense and National Security Committee are MPs Jamal Ali Bouhassan, Khalifa Abdullah Al-Ghanim, Dihab Muhammad Al-Naimi, Abdurrahman Rashid Boumjid, Abdullah bin Ali bin Huwail, Muhammad Hassan Al-Joder, Nabil Abdullah Al-Blushi. Members of the Services Committee are MPs Usama Abdul Hamid Al-Khaja, Jamal Dawood Salman, Dr. Jamila Mansour Al-Samak, Rua Abadir Al-Hayki, Abbas Isa Al-Mahdi, Ali Yaqub Al-Maqla, Isa Abdul Jabbar Al-Kohiji. And members of the Public Utilities and the Environment Committee are MPs Ibrahim Jum'a Al-Hammadi, Hamad Salim Al-Dosiri, Adil Abdurrahman Al-Asumi, Abdul Hamid Abdul Hussein Ahmed, Ghazi Faisal Al-Rahman, Muhsin Ali Al-Bakri, and Nasser Abdul Raza Al-Qasir. The Minister of Oil, Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, inaugurated today the first Middle East Fine and Specialty Chemicals Conference and Exhibition at Bahrain International Exhibition and Convention Center. The event was attended by chief executives, managers, engineers, college students, key figures in the fine and specialized chemicals industry, petrochemical importers, and potential investors. The aim of the conference is to exchange information and expertise, review the latest development in the field, and discuss the major issues related to oil and gas, construction, packaging, cars, and water management. The event will be held until the 11th of October on the sidelines of the 4th Middle East Process Engineering Conference and Exhibition MIPEC 2017, held under the patronage of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa. MEPIC was organized by Middle East Energy Events in cooperation with the National Oil and Gas Authority, NOGA, and the support of the American Institute of Chemical Engineers. In his opening speech, the oil minister welcomed the inauguration of the exhibition, expressing pleasure at Bahrain for being chosen to host the event, which reflects the kingdom's reputation in organizing the conferences and specialized expositions. He added that it also reflects the government's efforts to attract various events to Bahrain. Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa praised the efforts of the conference's organizing committee, underscoring the cooperation of NOGA in facilitating the event. The minister added that the event is considered the first of its kind in the Middle East. The Minister of Oil, Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, inaugurated the Bahraini Women Engineers Forum amid the presence of leading women engineers from institutions, governments, authorities, oil and industrial companies. The conference aims to shed light on the process of women Bahraini engineers' progress and their substantial achievements that contributed directly to the kingdom's development in all fields. The forum is held on the sidelines of the 4th Middle East Process Engineering Conference and Exhibition MEPIC 2017 and is organized by the National Oil and Gas Authority, NOGA, in cooperation with a number of affiliated gas companies. Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa hailed in his opening speech the celebration of the wife of His Majesty the King and President of the Supreme Council for Women, Princess Sabiqa bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, of Women, Bahraini Women, on December the 1st. He also commended the unlimited support women Bahraini women engineers received in both the public and private sectors from Princess Sabiqa bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa under the reform project of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. The Minister of Works, Municipalities, Affairs and Urban Planning, Isam bin Abdullah Khalaf, conducted an inspection visit to Hura and Ghdibiya today to take a closer look at the needs of their developmental project. The minister affirmed that these visits are in line with the directives of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, to meet the needs of the citizens. The minister directed the officials in the ministry to study at the submitted requests, and he redirected the officials in the capital municipality to step up inspection work in stores and to close down those that violate regulations in coordination with the Ministry of Commerce, as well as to set an inspection plan to detect violations and preserve the Bahraini social fabric. He added that the ministry is committed to implementing the government's work program and is employing its resources to achieve public benefit, noting that the ministry is prepared to implement all developmental projects within its specializations and according to available resources. The Undersecretary for Islamic Affairs at the Ministry of Justice, Islamic and Endowment Affairs, Dr. Farid Al-Muftah, received the representative of Bahrain and second place winner among 33 contestants of Moscow International Quran Reciting Competition in the Tilawa category, reciter Muhammad Samir Mujahid. Mujahid reflects the positive effect of the preparation program hosted by the Quran Affairs Directorate at the Ministry of Justice. The 18th edition of the Holy Quran competition was held under the patronage of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa as part of his continuous support to serving the Holy Quran and to local and international Quran competitions. It also reflects the support of the government to all activities and programs related to the Holy Quran.